Now then, how do? Welcome from me, David Hoyle, to yet another A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. This is show number 153 in our online YouTube series. Thanks for joining me. Thanks for all your requests, dedications, your emails, your messages in the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. There's some brilliant stuff being sent in. I've got a great subject for you this week as a result of one of those messages as well. We started today with music by Stephen Buller, played by the Yorkshire Imperial Band. That was called Festive Prelude. First came across that piece back in 1982 when we took part in our junior band in a competition at the Winter Gardens in Blackpool, and every band had to play that piece of music as part of their set. I really remember it being a windy day. We'd played our set and we wandered off up the promenade towards the North Pier, maybe a dozen of us, and we were all singing the last bit of the piece. We really, really enjoyed working on it. Our first march of the week is for James. James is in Matlock in Derbyshire, lovely part of the country. James says, I'm looking forward to Whit Friday, and I know I'm going to hear this march played several times by a number of the big bands. James says, this is my favourite march and I will never ever tire of listening to it. The Britannia Building Society Band playing here, George Allen's Knight Templar. Thank you. Knight Templar by George Allen, played by the Britannia Building Society Band. That was for James in Matlock, who's very much looking forward to Whit Friday and all the other March contests in the summer as well. Regular listeners Colin and Margaret are in Halifax. They've been in touch to request this week's overture. We love this piece of music, they both say, and particularly the end, which is very regal. Yes, it absolutely is a regal piece of music and a great listen too. The Foden's Band playing here the music of Beethoven, Egmont.
Thank you.
This week's overture, Egmont by Beethoven, played by the Fodens Band, that dates back to 1810, way back. But what a cracking piece of music. Colin and Margaret in Halifax, thank you very much indeed for that. yorkshirebrass@gmail.com was the email address that they used to get in touch. You can do the same with any dedications, requests, or anything you'd like to say. All I will say is please get in touch early. We are recording these shows quite some time in advance now for compliance purposes. Stuart in Whibsey has chosen this week's first solo. I'm a big fan of the Black Dyke Band, followed them since the Black Dyke Mills days, and John Clough is one of my all-time heroes, says Stuart. Could I please hear him playing the Blade and Racers? Absolutely. No problem, young man. This is an arrangement by Uncle Gordon, Gordon Langford. Quality as usual from Gordon Langford and brilliant stuff from John Clough on the euphonium. The Blade and Racers was the choice of Stuart in Whibsey and of course the Black Dyke Mills Band on that particular recording with the accompaniment. Elaine's in Lightcliffe. Can I take you back to 1978? Oh yes, you can. I was still at school then, but the quality of the music in the charts was something else, as Elaine says. I agree with you, there was some belting stuff around in the late 70s. And this was one of them by Billy Joel. Could I please hear the Brighouse and Rastrick Band playing some music from that famous music LP? Yes, you've got it in your collection. I have, absolutely. And it's one of my favourite LPs of all time. I think there's just so many stuff on there which work for brass band that you wouldn't expect. Let's have a listen to this one, My Life. Mm-hmm. My Life by Billy Joel, the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band, playing there from a recording in 1978. It was a vinyl LP called Music. That was for Elaine in Lightcliffe. Thank you very much indeed, Elaine, for your lovely message. We're in springtime, aren't we? How fabulous, says Karen in Halifax. Yes, these words, how fabulous. They can be used in two ways, can't they? You can genuinely mean it when you say to someone, how fabulous, brilliant. And it can also be a really sarcastic response. How fabulous. You know, Basil Fawlty used to do it on a regular basis. They're here, Basil. How fabulous. I just think they're two great words. Karen says, can I please hear some music from the Black Dyke Band from the CD Ground Force? It's coming up to gardening time, and I absolutely love it. You've chosen a cracker for this time of the year. Jim Parker's music, of course, was all over this CD, and this particular piece I really love. It's one of my favourites on that CD. It's called Tulip Parade. Lovely. Music from the BBC TV series Ground Force. Tulip Parade. You can just sort of see all the tulips, can't you, in a roundabout, all stood up very smartly like soldiers. Thank you very much indeed to Karen in Halifax for requesting Jim Parker's music. And it's a good CD by the Black Dyke Band. It was a great series. I used to love it. What have we got for the subject this week? Right. Our Ian's been in touch. He lives in Horsforth. And he directed me to a piece on the internet, which had actually been in a local newspaper, and he said, Oily, this is just you. I'd like you to cover it on the programme. It's things that people do that annoy others. We could be here all day with this one. But I'm going to stick to your list, Ian, and there's one thing that you've added into it, which absolutely works on this show. The first thing that comes up on this list is people not replacing an empty loo roll. It does so many people's heads in, doesn't it? If you empty the loo roll, put another one on and throw the old one away. It is not rocket science, says Ian. The shop, can I get? It keeps coming up, this one, doesn't it? Can I get? No please and no thank you, says Ian. That's the point. Someone goes into a shop, can I get a ham sandwich? Well, one, no, you can't get it because it's not self-service. And there's no please and there's no thank you. And Ian just says, how rude. Totally agree. Cyclists, you're not going to like the next one that Ian sent in. Cycling four abreast, chattering on a main road, a busy main road, with cars passing by. And bearing in mind now that you've got to pass at a certain distance, Ian says, I think it's dangerous. Yeah, I think you should think about these sort of things when you're out and about on, you know, on a cycling ride. It's not a brilliant thing to ride on main roads four abreast, in my opinion, either. Singing along like trying to win a Grammy when you've got your earphones in your ears. Oh, I saw somebody doing this the other day, and I don't think they realised actually that they were actually singing it out loud. God loves a trier, says Ian. More of these to come in a little while. Time for another soloist now. Tenor horn this time. This is for Nicola, who is in Salford. Could I please hear Herman Belsted's Capriccio Brillante, if at all possible? You certainly can. This is an arrangement by good friend of the show, Sandy Smith, and it's played here by Shona White with the Yorkshire Building Society Band. The Great arrangement by Sandy Smith of Herman Belstead's Capriccio Brillante. Shona White was playing the solo there on the tenor horn with the Yorkshire Building Society Band. A great recording, thanks to Nicola in Salford. That request came in on the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. If you're not a member, pop onto Facebook, look for Yorkshire Brass. You'll see our pictures come up. Ask to join the group, I'll add you in, and then you can talk to your heart's content with the rest of the guys in the group. And we're talking all about things brass banding. Morgan Langford coming up now. This is for Jim in Shelf. He said, I'd like you to play this for my wife Gwen. We love your show, we love brass banding music, big fans of the Black Dyke Band, and again, someone who followed the band right back in the day when it was the Black Dyke Mills Band. They did a number of recordings of Gordon Langford's music, did Black Dyke. It's all listenable, it's all good stuff, it's all quality, it's all arranged pretty much perfectly. In fact, I think the guy was a genius. This is another one of my favourite pieces of music. I absolutely love it. Phil, the Fluter's Ball. The Black Dyke Mills Band playing Gordon Langford's arrangement of Phil the Fluter's Ball for Jim and Gwen in Shelf. Thank you very much both. A lovely email and really appreciate your kind words. Now then, young Ben in Sheffield, how the devil are you? That's just what you say to me in your email. How the devil are you doing, Ollie? I'm absolutely grand. I'm always grand when I'm behind a microphone talking about brass bands, presenting brass band music and putting the world to rights. So there's nothing finer. The Dinnington Colliery Band CD was brilliant, says Ben in Sheffield, and I wonder if you could play my particular favourite from it. Yes, this was from the TV series a little while ago called A Band for Britain. This is the music of Klaus Badelt from Pirates of the Caribbean. The theme music from Pirates of the Caribbean by Klaus Badelt was played there by the Dinnington Colliery Band at the request of young Ben in Sheffield. yorkshirebrass@gmail.com once again, the email address if you want to get in touch with any requests. That's really the best way, my favourite way of receiving them, if I'm honest. Now then, let's go back to this list of things that people do or things that people say that annoy many others. Have you heard of a word called humble bragging? I haven't, but Ian in Horsforth, who sent this subject in, says humble bragging is sharing a personal victory on social media. Most people will sigh and say, oh, not again. Ian says once in a while is absolutely fine, but we don't need it every day. Ian, I can't disagree with a word that you said there. If you've got something to say, that's great, fantastic, but you don't have successes every day, do you? You know, once in a while, share it, share the love. How about replying on an email and pressing the reply all button when actually you meant only to reply to one person who was in that particular email? I know loads of people who have done this and you can't recall them after 10 seconds, can you? And you just think, oh dear, oh dear. Putting an item back on the wrong shelf at a supermarket. This I've seen many times. And Ian, you're quite right. You know, you go and you see something that's come out of one of the fridges at the supermarket and you're wandering down and out. It's by batteries and toilet rolls and things like that. Take it back, you lazy beggars. What's up with you? Absolutely. And this is the band one. This is the one that Ian's added for bands. Talking during a band concert. There is nothing more annoying. I compared a concert a little while ago. And there were a couple sat near the front of the concert. I'm not going to say where it was for obvious reasons. But they were sat maybe five or six rows back from the front. And they pretty much chattered all the way through the concert. It's not acceptable and it's not fair to the bands. Let's just quieten it down a little bit now, shall we? Let's have a quiet piece of the week. This is for Helen. Helen's in Tadcaster and she says, I'd love this piece to appear on the show. We played it in my band at the March and Hymn Tune contest last summer. And you know what? If we play it again this summer, it'll just do me fine. This is the music of Kenneth Downey, played here by the Sellers International Band in perfect peace. How lovely is that? In Perfect Peace by Kenneth Downey, played by the Sellers International Band at the request of Helen in Tadcaster. I've played that piece on a number of occasions. I've heard it played at the March and Hymn Tune contests in the summer. And some of the chords in that music are breathtaking. They literally take your breath away when you sit and you listen and you think, my goodness, that is just quality writing. Talking about quality music, well, we're going to end the first part of this week's show as we started it with a piece of music played by the Yorkshire Imperial Band. This is for Martin Stevenson. Martin's in Hamilton in New Zealand, an expat, a Bradfordian, and discovered the show a few months ago. Well, thanks for listening to us, Martin, and thanks for picking this piece of music. You've put me some Maori into this as well, and the end of this actually could be a bit of broad Yorkshire. But it's pronounced Kaki Te Anu. You see, Anu. That just sounds so much like broad Yorkshire, doesn't it? But actually, in Maori, it means see you again. Well, we hope we see you again with more requests on the show, Martin. But for now, as I say, it's the Yorkshire Imperial Band taking us to roughly halfway with the fabulous music of John Williams. This, another arrangement for brass band by Alan Catherall, the theme from Jurassic Park. Thank you. What an iconic piece of music. The main theme from Jurassic Park by John Williams, arranged for brass band by Alan Catherall and played there by the Yorkshire Imperial Band at the request of Martin Stevenson, a Bradfordian who's now living in Hamilton in New Zealand. We hope to hear from you again, my friend, in the not too distant future. We begin the second part of the show this week with a montage. This is for Jack. Jack's a regular listener and regular contributor in the Facebook group, the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. Jack said, I played this piece of music many years and I have heard you played it on your shows before, but it's not been on for a while. How about a rerun? Well, why not? Absolutely. The Black Dyke Band playing here, and this composition was made by Horatio Nichols. It's called Cavalcade of Marshall Songs. Cavalcade of Marshall Songs by Horatio Nichols was played for Jack by the Black Dyke Band. Some great melodies in there, and some sing-along bits as well. We're going to carry on the marching theme now as we go to Denshaw to play this one for Barry, who's got his birthday this week, and someone else who's getting ready for the summer marching season. Barry says, I love this march. and I wonder if you'd play it on your show to celebrate my birthday at the beginning of April. I just missed out on an April Fool's birthday. How dare I? How dare you indeed? This is the Hepworth Band and another march by George Allen, the Wizard. Thank you. Great March, The Wizard by George Allen, played there by the Hepworth Band, the second of George Allen's marches that we've heard on this week's programme. Happy birthday to Barry in Denshaw. We're going up to Cumbria now to St Bees. We say hello to Dennis. How are you doing, Dennis? Ex-Yorkshire, now happily living up on the Cumbrian coast. I wonder if you could please request the trombone solo Stardust by Hoagie Carmichael. You certainly can. This is an arrangement by John Iveson, and it's from a fairly new recording featuring Brett Baker with the JSVB Legacy Band. Wonderful, that's a lovely piece of music, isn't it? Stardust by Hoagie Carmichael. John Iveson's arrangement for brass band was played by Brett Baker on the trombone with the JSVB Legacy Band. Dennis in St Bees in Cumbria, thank you very much again, and a very, very happy birthday. Right, list time. Let's go back to this list of things that people do that annoy others. Thanks to Ian in Horsforth for sending this one in. RSVP, yes, please reply if you get an invite. People get fed up with stuff like this because they're trying to arrange an event, you know, a party or something, to get an indication on numbers for food and things like that. Some people just don't bother to reply but then turn up, and then there's not enough food for everybody. Or they reply after a date, you know, you might get RSVP by the 1st of April, for example, and someone replies on the 15th of May. What's that all about? If it says reply by the 1st of April, please do it. How about eating loudly? Ian, I've heard people do this, especially if it's a dish that they really like. They just chew it and chew it and chew it and start singing, don't they? I have come across people doing that. Final one for now. Heads down in a phone whilst walking. Totally oblivious. Yeah, this is dangerous actually on a number of counts, because one, you might bump into someone. Two, you might not realise that you're crossing a road. And three, you might walk into a lamppost. And if you do, well, it's your own stupid fault, isn't it? What have we got coming up next? Oh, a bit more music again from this 1978 Brickhouse & Rastrick music LP. The old maroon LP, as Neil in Home Fair. I tell you, you love this one. At Neil's birthday this week, he says, I was but a lad in 1977 when this music first came out, and I think this is a fabulous arrangement for brass band. Could you please play me It's a Heartache, the song that Bonnie Tyler took into the charts? Certainly can, Neil. Happy birthday. One of only a few brass band recordings where the end of the track actually fades away. The music of Ronnie Scott and Steve Wolfe, It's a Heartache, The music was taken into the charts, of course, by the great Bonnie Tyler. The brass band version's not too shabby either, is it? Brighouse and Rastrick Band playing there from their LP Music from 1978. Sue in Murfield is up next. Can you explain the story behind this piece of music? Because I've been told a story and I can't believe it's right, says Sue. Here we go. The story goes with this piece of music that it was written by the composer Derek Bourgeois for his wife to walk down the aisle to on the occasion of their wedding. So you would expect something sort of, you know, trumpet voluntary-esque, wouldn't you? Something a bit sort of regal. Well, this is certainly not regal. It's different. And the story goes, whether this is true or not, but I've heard this story told by a number of different people, that at the time of the wedding, Derek's future wife had a broken leg and therefore couldn't do a normal walk down the aisle. If that's true, this is an absolute genius arrangement. It really is, because you can almost feel it happening. Let's have a listen. This is the Leyland Band playing Serenade. The Leyland Band playing Serenade by Derek Bourgeois. If the story's right and Derek's wife had a broken leg at the time of the wedding, you can just feel the walk down the aisle. I'd love to know if the story is absolutely true. But Sue in Murfield, thank you very much for sending that one in. Now, as you know, this weekend, April 1st and April Fool's Day and all that, there'll have been all sorts of things in the newspapers and online trying to fool people. And I just thought it was appropriate that we maybe put a couple of pieces of music into this week's running order, which contained the word fool. How dare I? The first one goes back to 1962. Now, I have to be honest, I'd never heard of this piece of music, but it's a power ballad from the musical Stop the World, I Want to Get Off, written by Anthony Newley and Leslie Brickis. Okay, the Grimthorpe Colliery Band are going to play this one. And what's more interesting as well, really, is that it got a nomination in 1963 for the Grammy Awards for Song of the Year. I honestly would have thought I would have heard of this before. Let's have a listen. It's called What Kind of Fool Am I? Maybe I'm the Fool. The music of Anthony Newley and Leslie Brickis, played by the Grimthorpe Colliery Band. What Kind of Fool Am I? From the 1962 musical Stop the World, I Want to Get Off. The fool theme continues, given that it's April Fool's Day, with this one. This is a composition by Gustav Holst, and it's an opera in one act. Almost 10 minutes, but this is a really, really great listen, and it's played by the Sun Life Stanshaw Band. Lots of Sun Life Stanshaw fans listen to this particular show, and we thank you for doing that. This took almost 4 years to complete by Holst, and eventually it got its performance, the performance, in 1923. So it's 100 years old. 14th of May, so we're 6 weeks shy of this music being 100. Here we go, the Sun Life Stanshaw Band playing Gustav Holst's The Perfect Fool. Thank you.
Thank you.
You know, I think that's a smashing piece of music. The Perfect Fool by Gustav Holst was played by the Sun Life Stanshaw Band. 100 years old next month. Back to this list by Ian in Horsforth of things that people do that annoy others. And Ian says most of these will annoy you. They do. We're absolutely on the same wavelength. Jumping a queue. Now, this is an absolute beauty. Let me tell you something that I saw happen a few weeks ago. We were in a queue, the First Lady and I, we just got off an aircraft and we were queuing for customs. It was a long queue and there were people on, there were people from our flight and one or two of them had caused issues and they thought it was funny that some of them just decided to visit the washroom and then jump the queue to stand with the mates who were further down the line. What they didn't realise is that they were being watched on CCTV, and when you got to the bottom of the first ramp, you were then put into sections as to which bit you were going to go through, which desk and everything. And the security officer was fantastic. He actually put them in the longest queue. We were lucky. We got in the shortest one. Another one. This is another one. I'm going to do this. I hope the mic picks this up. Pen clicking. Damned irritating. Especially in a quiet room. Pushing into a lift before people have exited. Yeah, this is the same thing as getting off a train and on it. You know, you get, people try to get on a train before people have got off. It's so irritating. Final one for now, and then we'll do the last little run. When someone starts a sentence with the words, "no offence," Ian says, you know damn well it's going to be offensive. You do. It's absolutely true. I've loved having these, Ian, on the show. Thanks for taking the time and trouble to send them in. And if any of you want to do something, you know, choose our subject of the week, then get typing. I'm asking for requests now, so I'm going to play this piece of music by Leroy Anderson. The Yorkshire Imperial Band, play the typewriter. Get them fingers going. yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. Get typing. I'd love to hear things from you that not only a musical request, but things that you think we can talk about on our weekly rants and raves. Nigel in Tamworth has chosen this week's test piece. Thank you for this, Nigel. Played this one maybe 33 years ago, and I've loved it ever since. This is the music of Gilbert Vinter, played here by the Williams Fairy Band. This week's test piece, Triumphant Rhapsody.
Thank you.
This week's test piece, absolutely fabulous, wasn't it? Triumphant Rhapsody by Gilbert Vinter, played by the Williams Fairy Band for Nigel in Tamworth. Let's finish this list off, half a dozen more things from Ian in Horsforth about things that people do or say that annoy others. Late stays in a pub, says Ian. Let me tell you, I remember this, when shutting times in the pubs changed from 10:30 to 11 o'clock, I remember a number of people who simply came out half an hour later. And I used to think, why? Why do you do that? There was a sign in my local in the 1980s. It was a big bright yellow sign with black letters on it. And it simply said, if you want to stay longer, come earlier. And it's one of the best signs I've seen in my life. It summed it up perfectly. Absolutely. Blowing bubble gum, or blowing that big bubble and then having it all go all over your face, says Ian. No, absolutely not. One from social media, says Ian. Do people actually have set things that they just copy and paste? Because you see some people put in the same post and the same words as last time, but with a different name. Yes, I think I kind of know what you mean in that. Smelly food for work lunch. Oh, yeah, you don't want people sat in your staff works area having something like a smelly piece of fish. And come to think of it, you don't really want to be sat next to someone in rehearsals who's had fish for the tea either. It's not very nice. The last one, this of all of them, Ian, I've left this until last because this is the one that really does annoy me. And you get people in a queue, and they might queue for 15 minutes, and there might be two of them, and then they get to the front. Can I help you? What would you like? What do we want? You've had 15 minutes to think about it. It's absolutely irritating. Ian, thank you very much indeed for choosing this week's subject. It's been great and an absolute joy to read them out. George is in Leeds. This week's hymn tune is Your Choice, Young Man. 68, Oily Please, from the Red Hymn Book, although this is not from the Red Hymn Book. It's a different arrangement, but it's one of my favourite hymns. Not heard enough, says George. I agree. The Grimthorpe Colliery Band play the music of Charles Skinner, Penlan.
Thank you.
It's a grand little hymn, that, isn't it? Penland by Charles Skinner was played by the Grimthorpe Colliery Band. George in Leeds with that one in the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. Carlin Bolton has sent the final request in on the email, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. Now, this is an absolute belter. Not one band, not two, not three, but four. Four mass bands. Desford Colliery, Carlton Main Frickley Colliery Band, Whitburn Borough Band and the Leyland Vehicles Band, all together, all playing an absolute masterpiece. Thanks for listening again. This was show number 153 in our online series, A Bit More Yorkshire Brass, with me, David Hoyle. Back, of course, next week with 154, but we sign off this week with those four wonderful bands playing for Carl in Bolton. John Williams, Superman Suite. Thanks again. See you soon. Ta-ra.